As you said, it's been a big week right here. There's been a lot of chatter. People are talking.
People are talking.
People
as
are talking.
I like to say, my friend Julie Tremaine and I, as you know, have co-authored a Seinfeld-inspired cookbook. Now, you all know how much I love Jerry Seinfeld and Larry David, how much I love the cast, how the show has really helped to shape my comedic sensibility, yada, 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 all that. I promise I will stop talking about this incessantly eventually, but guys, I think you're really gonna like what's coming up here. Are you ready?
Ready. Yeah.
There's been a promotional blitz. I'm tired of it. Will, you love it.
I think it's, look, I honest to God, I love every second of this. I think it's fantastic.
It needs to continue through the holidays for sure.
All right, well, I've been on various TV and radio shows, including, get ready, an Australian TV show. I'm not kidding.
No, this is
awesome.
Real. Like,
all
this
right.
is real.
Wednesday evening at 6:45 p.m. Eastern Time from my home, the Kirby Castle, I dialed up Zoom, and I connected with the very affable hosting duo of Sylvia Jeffries and David Campbell of Today Extra, which I'm told emanates from the Nine Network Studios in North Sydney.
Okay.
So it was the evening here, but over there it was the morning, and they were live on the air doing a show just like ours on the other side of the planet.
This is so cool.
That's right. Australia got a dose of Brendan Kirby as I promoted the Seinfeld cookbook. Here are some of the highlights. I think you'll enjoy this.
Now, you will be able to bring all this into your own home, finally, with the release of the official Seinfeld cookbook. And we are absolutely delighted to say one of the co-authors, Brendan Kirby, joins us now from Rhode Island. We salute you, sir.
Hey, Brendan.
And thank you for your service. This looks incredible. What inspired you to create a cookbook for the show?
Well, first of all, before we get into any of your hard-hitting exposé, I just have a question for you. I'm coming to you all the way from Rhode Island in the United States, as you just said. Am I showing too much chest for the Australian morning TV audience?
No, not at all.
You've got room for two more buttons to go down,
okay,
my friend.
Yep.
Keep going, mate.
You're okay.
Because as we all know, as Seinfeld taught us, the second button really makes or breaks the shirt.
That's
right. We're here to talk about the culinary offerings of the show. And first of all, you asked inspiration. And really, my co-author, Julie Tremaine, the two of us, we really felt that Jerry Seinfeld and Larry David could use the extra cash. So why not put out this book for everyone to enjoy?
Have you had any interaction with any of the cast members? Have they had any input or say in this book?
Oh, no, they all have restraining orders against me. That's not happening. All kidding aside, I'm joking. I'm told that Jerry knows about it. It's the official Seinfeld cookbook, so it has been licensed. You know, the publisher made sure that we got all of the licensing, the logos, the pictures, stuff like that, and we could really use all the things we needed. I'm told Jerry knows about it. Guys, I've always wanted to meet Jerry Seinfeld and Larry David. I'm hoping maybe this is like the first step to that happening.
You never know. The first bright white sneaker step to that happening, my friend. Congratulations. We're a huge fan of this book, and we appreciate it, Brendan. Well done, mate.
Congrats.
Thank you. I host a morning show in Providence, Rhode Island, so it's great to be on with you. I know what it is you do. This is a great connection. How much fun. Come see us on the Rhode Show if you're ever in Providence.
Well, we would love that.
Well, you make sure you invite us when you meet Larry and Jerry.
Yeah,
we want to be there.
It will do it. Talk show host exchange program.
Quite like that. We like that a lot. Thanks, Brendan. Take it easy.
See you soon.
How much fun was that?
I love it!
So, guys, you'll go over there. They'll come over.
Let's go.
Kayla of Australia. So,
let's go.
So much fun, and I thought you might get a kick out of that.
So funny.
Absolutely. Australia's always been on my bucket list, and now I got people to stay with.
Now we've got a connection. I got the Roadshow name out in Australia.
Yes.
Unbelievable.
Fantastic.
We'll grab the Roadshow car then.
Let me know how that goes. Yeah. Well, here we are on a Friday morning, and I'm very excited about that because I've now disappointed audiences on two separate continents. Really, my life's work is complete. Let's discuss today's show, shall we? As if you haven't had enough entertainment this morning, right? You've seen the Roadshow as a sitcom. We've seen my appearance on Australian TV, but there's even more. We'll chat with our friends Nairobi to get the scoop on Armenian Fest. We've got an always scintillating buzz topic to get to. We're learning how you can make strides against breast cancer and so much more. So let's keep the show rolling by sending it over to Will, who made his way into the kitchen.